My name is Peter, I'm an Arsenal fan, I'm joined by Adrian, a Liverpool fan.
No time for cute little slogans, 11 wins boys, that's it.
That's what you want. And I'm joined by Oscar, a Chelsea fan.
We're gonna win the league, and now you're gonna believe us,
We'll see about that. I'll tell you who's definitely not gonna win the league. Arsenal losing 3-1 at Anfield.
Holy cow.
Yeah, same old story. I have nothing to say about this because we turned up. It was the same lackluster performance. No fight, no guile, nothing.
No guile. What is guile?
Yeah, a bit of flair, a bit of, you know,
something.
You know what I mean?
Guile.
Some paprika season.
Sounds like something you might get in Chile. Something that Alexis Sanchez could have provided to the squad.
Speaking of which, what on earth was he starting on the bench for? Someone explain to me what was the manager thinking when he decided.
Do you know what it was, yeah? When I first saw the team sheet, I was like, rah. But I backed it. Because I was like...
You backed what?
I backed the decision, innit? Because I was like, it's a bold move, yeah? And I just thought, like, I thought starting Giroud was a good thing. That's what I thought, yeah? And I thought, if it's a straight swap Giroud for Sanchez, then maybe Wenger's got a tactic. Maybe he's got something he's put up his sleeve and he said, we're going to play a certain way and do this.
Do you realise he was injured?
Who?
Giroud. You know he was injured, right?
But I saw it was in the game.
No, he was injured from before. He was injured before the game, then he got another kick in the game. He had a knock-on from a previous match, and then he was injured anyway. So I cannot understand how your best player, and probably one of the best players in the Premier League this season, starts on the bench for an injured Olivier Giroud at that.
Listen, there's Big Daddy Wings. Like he's laying down the law.
On a real
wild rest.
Wenger's committing suicide, man. He's committing suicide. He's actually killing himself. Because the thing is, if you say to me, you know, because he makes up this thing about I want to go more direct. I mean, hello. Sanchez is probably the most direct player we have in our team. Correct me if I'm wrong. If he meant height, that's a different scenario.
Probably directs as a long ball.
To look at
that Arsenal team, that Arsenal starting 11, and you see Sanchez and Ozil both not in the squad. As a Liverpool player, you're thinking, let's have it.
No, because it's all in sight. Let's
have it. Let's beat them. And they did in the first half. They came out and they said,
it's a sad state of affairs. We could finish out of the top four. And I've never felt like that before. I've never felt like we could finish out of the top four before. I genuinely am worried.
So that means lower than Spurs?
Oh, yeah. I think Spurs this year will finish above us, even if we finish in the top four.
Cracky.
I think they will finish above us. Because, like... I'm so sorry.
It's happened again.
No, on the real, like... Put it this way. If we finish above Spurs still, don't ever bring Spurs into this conversation again. Don't even bring them near my... I don't want to hear it near my ear ever again.
Because, you can't chat about Spurs.
No, but that's my point. I said if we finish above
them... No, but if they finish above you, you can't say nothing to them.
Well, no, of course not season.
That's his point. Basically, he's saying that, like, they're so far gone.
Yeah, it's
so... Like, for them to throw it away now...
And it's not to say that they haven't thrown it away in the past, because they do throw it away quite often, but this sort of year, the way that, you know, I'll be honest with you, this season, right, you name me how many games where you thought, Arsenal were sick this season. You will struggle to do it in one hand. Ludogorets home and away, Chelsea at home. It's a game, isn't it? Ludogorets home and away, Chelsea at home, and I'm going to go with Southampton away. I won't even give you Hull because that was a bit funny as well. It was a bit ropey in the beginning. Sunderland away, I'll give you. There's your five. Five games in March. By March, you're telling me I've only got five games where I can handpick and say, do you know what?
Right.
That's where Arsenal were good.
Adrian, was it a case of Arsenal being shambolic or was it Liverpool were good?
I think...
Considering what Liverpool did against Leicester.
I think it was Liverpool being good.
That's exactly what I said. Like, after the game, I was like, in that first half...
Listen, when you come to Anfield, when you come to the slaughterhouse... Come on. I was watching the game, and I noticed, I don't know what Wenger was doing. He was trying to do a thing. I saw Arsenal players sort of all back behind the ball, 10 man behind the ball, sort of trying to contain or something. I've never seen Arsenal do this before. Maybe at Man City when he won over there.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking, like, Wenger done something to negate our threat. But then I saw sort of Bellerin trying to expose our ineptities and our ineptitude on the at left, on the left-hand side. Yeah, but I thought you were just going to hack us, man.
I think that first half, Liverpool were good.
Do you know what? To me, I was saying to Oscar, I didn't think they were all that. Like, I felt like Liverpool were always there to be taken. Do you get? And when we got our goal, when we got our first goal in, in fact, when Giroud had that header and that world-class save from Mignolet, I thought, oh, Liverpool could get eaten right now. Like, give us 5-10 minutes of this form, we could be 2-2 in a heartbeat. And we really should have been, because we did do well. We finally kicked into gear. Liverpool's not a team that I don't know what's happened with Liverpool this term, this part of the season, like, you know, in terms of the 2017 sort of Liverpool. But there's just something that's just not quite right. And even in the win, there's not something I really took from that and thought, yeah, Liverpool are back. There's nothing, because that Leicester performance, by the way, I know we didn't do a pod after that, but goodness gracious me. That Leicester performance, I said, bring that Liverpool to Anfield, please, next week, because we'll take that.
It's just been typical Liverpool this season, right?
Still in my life.
This has been, but that Leicester performance, I think, is their worst of the season. That was the worst of the season.
No, but I mean, typical, oh, we're struggling against the lower team, but against the big team, we'll put up a performance. It's like...
I get what you're saying, but I think with the Burnleys and all that lot, and Bournemouths and that, they tried. I mean, with Burnley and... Burnley and Bournemouth, I'll tell you that, them games, they actually did try to nick something out there. But the Leicester performance, bruv, the Leicester performance was so bad.
Nothing.
They did nothing in that game.
Maybe Vardy looked like Aguero in that game.
Like, in the other games, you could always argue and say, you know what, Liverpool end up with 81% possession. They frustrate the hell out of that team. And then they get frustrated by not breaking it down. Leicester, they were garbage. They were you heard rumours of, what's his name, Jurgen Klopp's job being questioned, because you thought, if Arsene Wenger's getting this kind of stick, what the heck is Jurgen Klopp getting away with here? Because that Leicester performance was...
Klopp is in a different boat to Wenger.
He's in a different what?
He's in a different boat to Wenger.
No, it definitely is.
At Liverpool 20 years and...
No, it definitely is. What I'm saying is that level of performance can get you sacked. Like, it was so bad against Leicester. I think against Leicester, they were shocking.
What is it about Klopp here? Because he seems to have this reputation where people don't want to throw any speculation around about Klopp.
It's too young. It's too soon.
No, but I think any other manager...
It's too soon. Because he's got
people like Klopp.
They do like Klopp, but when you've won the title with Dortmund twice, you've been given grace for like a couple of years. Do you know what I mean? Even if you have a few bad years, you've been given the grace to do that.
He's had a few bad years.
Do you know what I'm saying? It's like a Wenger thing. Wenger's first 5-10 years were exceptional. That the second 10, he's been given a blight this whole time. So, Bob, at the end of the day, man, I mean. Welbeck getting pulled off. You know, after that Sanchez situation, you then take off Welbeck and the crowd turned. The crowd turned on him. It was a moment where it was like, okay, do you know what? I think every away fan that went, I think 90% of them had enough. 90% of them had enough and just said, you know what? It's time to go. That's the way that it seemed to be perceived. But yeah.
I think that leads me to, I'm sort of tired. I know we've sort of rehashed this debate over and over again, but in a word, I mean, like, come on, like, when is enough enough? I mean, like, it's tiring. Like, every big game is the same old story. You're devoid of motivation, of any real skill, any real desire to win that game. Like, where does it come from? Like, surely
I'm sure it must be.
Because let me not lie to you, yeah? This man, Arsene Wenger, I respect this man. He's come to this league and he's transcended the way we play football.
Mm.
And with his, you know, with his passing, his style, even his methods in terms of, like, training players. But come on now, like, it's poor. Enough is enough.
Yeah, I'm still not of that boat yet. I'm not in the Wenger out.
What would it take to put you in that boat? I feel like Wenger could do anything.
Like, what more could you do?
You could finish sixth and be like, all right, we'll go again next year.
I think for me, he has to finish. This is my personal opinion, and look, I'm not gonna get any. I'm gonna get abused for this, but I think for me, he has to finish outside of the top four twice, two seasons running. For me to say, because you know, I give a blow of one blip. I mean, he's been there 20 years, and he's got there 20 times.
But you're saying get there, like that's the destination that you.
It's not. But that's the thing. He's not getting sacked because he's not winning the league.
That's the McDonald's on the motorway.
He's getting sacked because people think he should be sacked.
It's a checkpoint along the way to a destination. That's a top four should be faster.
I think if you end up yourself in the Europa League places twice, I think that's when you know, okay, I don't think he can do it anymore. That's when I will start to believe he can't do it. Because at the end of the day, do you know what always keeps everybody optimistic at the beginning of a new season? It's how he always finishes the season before.
Yeah.
He's always poor in the middle part of the season. But because he ends on such a high, where we go into a new season, mm-hmm. and then he goes on another 10-game unbeaten run, and all of a sudden Arsenal 25 games unbeaten. It's like, where did those other 15 come from? It's because he ends the year so well that it's like, right now nobody has any optimism for Arsenal. We're all flat, right? So imagine he nicks top four and he nicks an FA Cup. Right now, any Arsenal fan right now will bite your hand off for that. They will bite your hand off for that right now.
This is manipulation.
Yeah, so do you get what I'm saying? It's so funny because I tell you what, if he lifts the trophy this year and we finish in the top four, sign on. Mm. Sign on, please. Go on.
I was going to say, because I wrote a piece. It's going to come out tomorrow when you lot get knocked out.
Let us know.
Yeah, that's
the time the anger will be heightened.
What's the piece?
Huh? About Wenger in, Wenger out. Because for me, I feel like it's a cycle wherein what's going to happen is you're probably going to play valiantly against Bayern Munich.
Mm.
It's going to be the odd goal that decides it. You're going to go into the spring. You're going to be murking it. You're going to find yourself like 5 points, 6 points behind whoever won the league.
Mm.
You're going to ask yourself, raw! what happened? We could have won the league. Let's go again.
Yeah.
Then what's going to happen? Wenger's, he's not going to sign the players he's meant to sign. It's going to be a big kerfuffle.
Yeah.
He's going to wait till the end.
Yeah.
His key player is going to get injured. And his league talent challenge is going to just fall apart. And it's going to be the same. Like, come on, we need to see something new now.
I agree with 99% of that. The 1% I'll tell you is that at Bayern Munich tomorrow, whereas we're recording this on a Monday, we are not going to be there tomorrow. We're not even going to give you a valiant performance. The squad is shot to pieces. The thing is, Lincoln, I don't know in it. I don't even know about Lincoln. That's how nervous I am. No, but I'm nervous, bruv, because the pressure is... See, that's where Arsenal crumble, when the pressure is high.
When it's high.
All right, so listen. You see this piece that you
when it's Stoke at home, 2-0.
So you said you're writing a piece about Arsenal, which is coming out tomorrow.
Yeah.
Now, what would happen if Arsenal, by some miracle, managed to knock Bayern out of the Champions League tomorrow night?
It negates pretty much 80% of my argument.
I love it, but you know what? Like, what's our next Premier League game after this weekend? I think it's West Brom away. I think it's the next Premier League game, right? All I want to do is fast forward to the West Brom game, and that's where you'll get your unbeaten run from.
Yeah,
you will get 10 wins from there.
Yeah,
because now no one expects nothing from Arsenal.
But I think you got to face City.
City's towards the end. We've got all the big guys at the end, like Tottenham, Man United, City, are all like April, May. They're all there.
But we're keeping dead players like Theo, who any other manager, Theo would have been gone 4 years ago. He's been at the club for over a decade. He only got to 100 goals.
But let me ask you something, though, because I read a stat today about Theo, and 370 games, he got 100 goals. When you think for a winger, is it that bad? I'm not trying to justify his goals, but is it that bad when you're a winger, you've got 370 games under your belt, you've got 100 goals? You know,
it's not that good. Because, I see what you're saying, because you think of it, it's almost like 1 in 3. But if you think about it, it's closer to 1 in 4 if he's played 370. Mm. That's closer to 1 in 4. And I just don't think...
Look at your wingers. Every 3-4 games?
Yeah.
I mean, you know,
Pedro this season.
Pedro, I guess Hazard is classed as a winger, isn't he? So yeah. I'll give you Hazard and Pedro. But Willian could get a goal in 5 games.
You're giving me Hazard and you're giving me Pedro. Willian doesn't always play with those.
All right, let's go to Liverpool's lot. Coutinho.
Coutinho's on a different
level. Maybe Sadio Mane.
Coutinho's on a different level. Mane, look how many goals Mane's banked this season.
He's got 12
goals. Man United, let's go to Man United. I'm looking for some wingers, isn't it? Because I'm thinking for Theo Walcott, the first 5 years of Theo Walcott's career, it's not really in existence. It's usually from the 2010 season, that's when he was in the first team, banging in the goals. That was when he was in the first team, really.
Yeah.
So that's why I'm a bit like... Oh, it's, you know what I mean? It's 10 years. It looks horrible. 10 That's 10 goals a year.
Ten goals a year.
But
the pesky numbers there.
You know, it's 10 goals a year, but at the same time, it's like...
In all comps as well, mind you.
Yeah, but anyway, you know what? I'm not, if someone says that's poor, fine. I'm not going to argue with you at all. But yeah, I think he's lost the dressing room legit. I think his players don't want to play. We've got players that don't have balls. We've got players that don't have fight. They haven't got nothing.
Point blank, period.
That's it. I'm looking at the picture. Xhaka and Coquelin, the worst players on the field against Liverpool. Coquelin got subbed at half time. That tells you everything. Wenger does not do a half time substitution for love nor money, right? So if you're getting pulled off, then you've had a shocking game. Sanchez smiling Friday. That's the bit that worried me the most. Sanchez was probably the most happiest player in Liverpool that day.
But was it a smile to say, oh, I'm happy we're losing? Or was it a smile to say, look what we've got here? Haha. So it's almost like he's so angry that he comes out in a smile.
I think he's laughing so much, he's like, oh, I ain't got to stand for this crap no more.
Yeah, can you put yourself in the shoes of Alexis Sanchez?
I think he's looking at his, I ain't got to stand for this.
You can't, because your souls will be hurting.
Playing out of your skin. You work so hard. Playing out of your skin, and you're like, arguably the best player in the Premier League this season, and your team are just letting you down.
No, there's like, too much going on here, because, you know, there's rumours about a row in the dressing room, you know, during the week, hence why he was dropped for Liverpool, mm-hmm. apparently, yeah. right? So you've been dropped for Liverpool, and then you're smiling, you're laughing, you came on the game, and you were playing like you're in a playground, he was having fun, he loved every minute of it. There's a part of me that thinks he knows where he's going next season.
Yeah, he's mentally checked out.
He's mentally checked out. So now he's like, listen, man.
Because we saw him against Bournemouth, and how livid he was. He was throwing his gloves on the ground. Yeah. He's furious that you guys have drawn.
Yeah.
But now against Liverpool.
Yeah.
And it's like, do you know what?
I think at Bournemouth, because at Bournemouth is where I think the title did go. I mean, it's when our hopes of actually winning the league went.
Yeah.
And so I think that's when he knew that. And so I hate the phrase, he's a winner. I hate that crap here. But he's somebody who wants to win all the time. Because who doesn't want to win, right? Yeah. But he wants to win all the time. And when he loses, he's pissed.
It's so weird because he's probably a sore loser, and that's the kind of thing you tell kids not to be.
And that's what we but need. You kind of we need don't have that. The thing is, we don't have that at Arsenal.
And we don't have that in England as well. That's why we always get knocked out in the last 16 of a competition, if we're lucky enough to get that far.
Yeah.
It's because, you can't be a sore winner. No, you have to be nice to Billy's feelings. Don't give a damn about Billy. Go and win the race. You know what?
If by giving him a medal, if Wenger either gets sacked or he leaves, if Wenger either gets sacked or he leaves, it will be either that Bayern result or it will be that Liverpool result, because they were both just, it was out of this world.
I said Bayern result. You know, the tie's not over.
Yeah, it's not over, but what do you expect?
Essentially.
Honestly, say you're Chamberlain, yeah? You want to talk about being Sanchez.
He's played well recently as well.
Imagine being him thinking, I'm going into a game where I'm 4 goals down against Bayern Munich, and it's the first minute of the game.
Yeah, just how just do you bang eat? It. Like, what? Just bang what? You've got nothing to lose.
Because you know what's going to happen? Bayern could easily score another 3, by the way. Lest we forget. Because if we do go forward, we have to be smart as well. We can go on a break here, and then they counter us. 1-0, first 10 minutes. Could you imagine?
Yeah,
we concede early goals, by the way, as well. So, Liverpool was how many? I couldn't believe how quick the Liverpool goal was. But I always said that it was coming. Like, I was telling somebody next to me, I was like, they're going to score a second as well. And the ball got whipped in and they scored a second. And I said, there you go. This team, they look pathetic. Mm-hmm. This Arsenal side looks so pathetic.
I think
that's the word I've got.
Sorry excuse.
This season, they have been pathetic. That's what I want to do. The only guy who hasn't, Alexis Sanchez. There's nobody else I can call out. There's no one else. I'm not happy with anyone else in that team. Well, Danny Welbeck, of course.
Bellerin?
No. Danny Welbeck gets substituted, he comes off, he's sitting on the bench, obviously he's livid. We're all singing Danny Welbeck for the rest of the game, as if he's to come on. It was, where is our manager? That's the chance that we're going on. Liverpool just felt sorry for us. Your fans weren't even giving it the full, you know what I mean? We were giving it sign on, we were giving it all that banter. And then after a while, everyone just went quiet. Because it's not surprising, but it's... same old Arsenal.
Yeah, I think that's always the inevitability of it. It's like,
yeah.
I mean, why are we angry? Why are we surprised?
I do want people in the club to grab a hold of something and just say, do you know what, guys, we can't have this again. Yeah. Next season, this cannot be the case. So write the season off, and get and start. No, I'm being serious. Write it off.
Because
guess what? See, you know what? I'm not. You know what I'm not on. You know what I'm not on. I'm not on beating Lincoln and then losing the semi-final to either Spurs, Man United, or Chelsea. I'm not on it, bruv. I'll be more livid then.
So you'd rather tap out at Lincoln?
Tap out at Lincoln. Listen, I'll tap out at Lincoln.
Cut your losses.
No, let me not say that because you're in the competition, isn't it? I'm just speaking out of emotion. But who do you see us? Do you see us winning the FA Cup final? Do you even see us beating?
Yeah, that's your team, you know. I can see you not winning.
Not when, but man, we've won it when you lot are in around.
You might get Millwall in the semis,
well,
you know.
We're gonna knock United out. So
come on, Borough. I'll have a Borough semi-final any day. Oh, Borough. No, Man United will beat you at Stamford Bridge. I'm so sorry. Because they've got nothing to lose.
Man United
are the ones that have something to prove here.
Without Zlatan, they're going to beat us.
Why was that Zlatan?
Zlatan has been banned because of his actions against Bournemouth.
What a tool. For goodness sake. Has he?
Yeah.
Moron. And he got stabbed in the head, though.
Yeah, he did get stabbed in the head.
So what, Tyrone Mings? Both of them,
yeah.
So he got banned as well?
Yeah.
My man gave him a curb stomp.
Can we go over there now? Do you want to talk anything else on Liverpool?
I can't lie. There's a lot I want to say about Liverpool, yeah? Mm-hmm. And like, when I was watching that game,
yeah,
I loved every moment of it. Yeah, I felt so angry when the final whistle blew. And the reason for that is because I sat there and I thought to myself, what a magnificent performance. I saw Clavin do his thing. He was solid. I saw our midfielders were excellent. Up front, the movement, the fluidity was...
One negative thing about Liverpool, from a Liverpool's perspective, Nathaniel Clyne and Sanchez, oh my God. Clyne was getting battered against Sanchez. Mm.
I mean, don't let that dampen the whole club.
It's a world-class winger against a right-back, a very, very good right-back at that. Yeah. And I saw this guy panting. You know, like, Clyne was panting of breath every, like, 10 minutes.
And one thing Alexis done,
deer.
Yeah?
As the deer.
One thing Alexis did as well was he negated Klein's attacking threat from the right.
Yeah,
so
absolutely.
Klein became a defender again.
Do you know how incredibly difficult that is to do? That's a massive skill. I don't think people realise too tough that if a winger is that good that it stops the right back from getting forward because he's always got a problem to
do. And that was one of the arguments of why Sanchez not starting was a bad idea because Liverpool's... Like that wing was felt free.
Free.
They could attack.
He was there. Manuel wasn't
what
there.
What I couldn't figure out, though, Coutinho kept picking the ball up by himself. Every time Coutinho gets a touch on the ball, he's in space. We're talking, this place was crowded.
Was Coquelin playing?
Was he playing?
Because, honestly.
It's a very good question.
Coutinho, acres of space. He could have built a house if he wanted to. At that much space. I don't understand.
Lallana had a great game as well.
Lallana doing what he does, man. Doing what he does. He's a very good player.
I feel like there's one player who, off the ball, he was terrible. But on the ball, he was very good.
I will say this,
and
though.
I'm sure
you know
can
what?
Guess who I'm talking about.
Say that again.
Off the ball,
yeah,
he was kind of terrible and almost cost this team the game. But on the ball, he was just excellent.
For Liverpool?
Yeah.
Who?
Emre Can.
Oh, goodness me. Do you know what? You know I've backed Chan for time, innit? Bro?
I didn't think he was that bad.
He should have got sent off.
How the heck did he remain on the pitch and then Koscielny get booked or Xhaka get
booked? It was Matip's way he backed it.
Because
to the referee, when the referee was weighing up the options, Matip was slapping his chest.
Could somebody tell me why our player was booked in that scenario when Chan was rolling over the ground?
Because Xhaka needs to know when to shut his mouth.
No, but on a real though, like, this guy was rolling on the floor and we're looking at this situation like, this guy is actual scum. Get up. You're not hurt. You didn't get touched. You fouled us.
Is his ankle swollen? Did you not see? His ankle swollen.
Nah, he got swollen by something else.
You see what Matip done, yeah?
Yeah.
Matip is that boy that you have in the passenger seat, yeah?
Yeah.
Like, when you get caught speeding, he is the boy that switches sweets with you and he takes the points. That's what Matip done. That's what
Matip done. No, big up to Matip. He was solid as ever. You know what I'm saying? It was solid as ever. But you were saying something.
No, I was just saying, I was angry at the end of the game because I can't help but thinking all the big teams we come, none of them beat us. We've beaten most of them this season. Yeah? Mm. Play magnificently well. Mm. We accumulate a certain number of points. So now I'm thinking to myself, surely, I mean, is it ridiculous of me to ask us to beat Swansea at home? To ask us to beat Hull away, Leicester away? When you accumulate those points now and you add them up, we should be a lot closer to the top of the league that we are. And I feel like we've blown the league this season. And that's why I was so angry. Because it's like,
I'm with you.
Look how magnificent, what a phenomenal performance. Every single player on that pitch gave it 110%. They were on it. They were on the ball. They done what they had to do. Go home. So like, why can't we do it when we're playing Burnley? You know what? As you said before, you know what? Football's football. Some things happen. Yeah, you might get the odd Burnley game here or there. You might get the odd Bournemouth game here and there. But then when we started getting the Leicester game, the Hull game,
that's the
Swansea game.
Oh, that Swansea game. Oh.
So there must be a problem somewhere that hopefully Jurgen Klopp can fix.
Swansea, well, I think, was unlucky. Because, Swansea had three shots, three goals.
Yeah.
You know, Liverpool scored two at home and still lost. Mm. You get it. So there's parts to play. Don't get me wrong, the defending was god-awful. Yeah. But Leicester, for me, is that's the performance.
Oh, no, that was a single-handed worst.
It's that one right there. Because as much as people were talking about Leicester coming back, I was in shock. I said, we've got these guys next Saturday. I beg you. I beg that team turn up like that. Because I do think that if Mignolet doesn't save that Giroud header, it's a different game.
Who knows?
I literally, because it was the first minute of the second half. Yeah. I thought,
the tides.
Honestly, he saved it right in front of me. I thought, this is a world-class save. Mm. This is
unbelievable. I remember that's what I said about Mignolet. I think he's a pants keeper, but at least he has that odd save here or there. That makes you go, you know what?
Yeah. No, with you. I'm with you. Liverpool, you know, good luck to you lot, man. I hope you lot do finish in the top four. No, I'm being serious. Like, I do hope you lot finish in the top four.
Thanks, bro. I hope so too.
Because out of the lot, I hate you lot the least. No, I hate you lot second least. Like, the least I hate City. Is City. Yeah, I have nothing to...
You're indifferent.
No, I'm indifferent with City.
Yeah, just City, apathetic.
City,
like,
I cool. don't like City.
City, I don't mind.
No, City or City. Yeah, like, I don't exactly. dislike them.
I have no beef with City at all. Anyway, and Liverpool's next. And then, you know, obviously I hate Tottenham, I hate Chelsea, I hate United, all the same. So, you know, if I can get those three out of the top four, fine. But yeah...
Would you mind, like, be the sacrificial lambs as well?
What, who us?
So obviously, like, one of them come out, but you come out with them.
Nah, it's not like that for me, man. Nah, it's not like that.
You don't
me.
Hear that much, yeah.
That's just sad. Do you know what? That's
it's racist start. To go down to the wire, man. It's going down to the last
I'll
day.
Tell you what, it will go down to the it's end.
Go down to the last
mark
day.
My words, from West Brom onwards, 10 win till we face Tottenham. Literally.
100%.
That's
yeah.
why it all comps, because you don't have 10 games left.
Well, yeah, I'm sure we do.
Who are you facing next?
West Brom away.
Oh, you've got West Brom?
Yeah,
okay,
West Brom away.
Ah, yeah, you've got 10 games then.
We've got West Brom, we've got West Ham, we've got Sunderland, we've got Leicester.
Have Stoke still?
We have Stoke, we have got United, we have got Man City, and we have got Spurs. Those are the three that I'm like, those are going to be, and I'm talking 6-pointer games where someone's going to be nicking points off each other, definitely. You know, so it's all to play for. It's all to play for. And you know what? Yeah. Anyway, Man United 1-0against Bournemouth. Flipping hell. Bournemouth had 10 men for 45 minutes.
I can't explain it. You know, I can't articulate it.
I would have bet my house that United were going to leave sixth place this weekend. But they didn't. They're still sixth.
Listen.
They are still sixth.
And it's funny because Mourinho's press conference was this year, and I didn't even deep it, bruv. He turned around and said, you know, Liverpool are playing Arsenal, meaning someone is losing ground.
So something's going
to give. Something's going to give. So it's the perfect opportunity for us to break into this. And that's when I started thinking, oh no, he's got whiff of this. Like, he smells blood. No, because you know what it is? Well, if Mourinho smells blood, it's game on. Like, there's no stopping him. If you give him a chance to pounce on something, that's it.
Like a shark in the
water. When that man told me, bruv, you know, like, it was 1-0 Man United? I said, all right, game done. You know, paid no attention, nothing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Paid nothing, yeah? Then I found out, Ibrahimovic missed the penalty. Now, I don't know, was this before the Bournemouth goal or after?
After.
See, I found out Ibrahimovic missed the penalty, me thinking it's still 1-0 Man United, because I did not care for this result whatsoever. Yeah, yeah, yeah. But you got fans on the coach, like, when we're going up to Anfield, like, Zlatan has missed the penalty, get in. So I'm like, what's there to rave? You know what I mean? Like, it's 1-0 Man United, game over. So we're doing, like, these predictions at the end of the journey, and I see Man United have a point. And I was like, why don't you got a point? And they go like, no, they drew 1-1. Oh my god!
Literally, when I was like watching the game, it wasn't like a thing of like I'm excited that Bournemouth are doing a thing here, because I was just like, it's just a matter of time before United get the winner.
Mm.
Like, it just seemed inevitable. United were pressuring a lot. Like,
I can just hear Ernest screaming on listening to his pod, because he's thinking, look, I've told guys from day, man, you know, you can't even bank a house on it. You just can't, and it's showing. Like, this season at home, Burnley haven't won still, a
still,
week.
He still managed to finesse the penalty at Old Trafford, when it wasn't
it? Yeah, of course. I mean, yeah, so Trafford. So Trafford. I mean, you know, that Stratford end and the Kop end, there's no difference. You will feed the penalty. What? You will feed
the penalty? No. There's been years past.
Oh, my God. Dubious.
Yeah,
dubious. Mate. Oh, of course.
Dubious to say the very least.
Oh, my God. I've never...
It's because it's the raw. It's the raw of the Kop, bruv.
It's the...
It influences the refs.
But I've seen times where Gerrard has wiped his boot thinking... Yeah, pen.
That's a little thing where he rubs his shirt down.
And the referee hasn't given it, and he's like, no, you don't understand.
This is Anfield.
This is Anfield. Exactly. What do you understand? It's the same at Man United. I mean, when Rooney goes down in the penalty area, Stratford end, guaranteed penalty. There's not even a question. There's
no question. What was the penalty decision this time? What was the thing?
I didn't see it.
It was a silly handball wearing.
Man crossed the ball, and then like,
it was like two yards away.
2 yards away, yeah. It was a handball. It was just so.
And then
silly.
The stupidest thing, there was like an incident where to give Man United should have had a free kick, where the same player done the same thing, but it was way further away. The referee didn't give it, but they gave the penalty.
And Man United fans actually argue. They generally think like decisions don't go their way.
I'll be honest with you. They've got a point. I can't lie.
Huh?
No, I've
I think they've got a point.
Huh?
Since Fergie,
have you not watched the Premier League this season?
No, but since Fergie,
have you not watched the Premier League?
Yeah, exactly.
Since Fergie, though.
Post Fergie,
no, but Oscar. Watched the Premier League this season.
I have.
How many goals have Man United scored that were offside?
Yeah, fair, fair.
I count like five, like six, bro. Yeah, how many handballs have they scored?
No.
Ridiculous.
No,
like as in. A handball in the build-up play and the ball goes in the back of the net, United get the goal. I think it happened against Palace, Zlatan handballed it and they scored.
I mean, Joyce, I will say this.
Goals.
It was ridiculous.
Every week.
It was ridiculous they got offside goal in a cup final. That's when I said this is suicide.
This
is ridiculous.
In a cup final.
If there's one place you do not get this wrong, I'm sorry. You bring the TV.
Yeah.
Bring it out. Bring it out. Because, bro, they got replay vans in the stadium. Like, you can find out in seconds. Why is it? This is the thing I don't understand. Why is it only the referee's the only man that knows in the stadium whether it's a goal or not? Why is he the only one that doesn't know?
It's
like
ridiculous.
Like everyone knows what it is.
It's actually.
But only he doesn't know.
I've been so annoyed with.
I hear you on the United front, but Oscar, do you not remember the Fergie days?
No, but
do you not remember?
Look, I'm saying we're still here.
From listen,
we're still here, blood.
Fergie was a cheeky little sucker because he used to take in the referees into his office for wine after the game. You can't do that.
No, you can't even do that. Wenger used to ask, "What's the point of the fourth official? What's
the point of an assistant?
What's the point of the fifth official on the goal?"
I always say, like, when Fergie left, he forgot to cancel his standing order into the referees. So money is still getting paid. These men are still taking the bribes. Fergie forgot about it. And then it's just
the direct
debit. They're still like, okay, we've got to do the D for United.
The dark thing is, it never gets put into question. Like, you don't hear media coverage of it the next following days or whatever. They've got this whole thing on Sky Sports called Ref Watch, and they never talk about any Man United decisions.
Well, they're all this week,
can't they? I don't know, you know. Who knows? We'll see, innit?
It's mad. But, United have stolen points this season. I'm not going to lie to you.
Because you know what? In one hand, you think United should be nowhere near, but if you're. Just like your frustration as a Liverpool fan this season.
The Mkhitaryan scorpion kick that everyone's like, oh, should be going this season. What's the one thing against it? It's offside. And there's tons of examples like that for United this season.
It's a funny
cycle. But you know, like, I was saying, like, if you're a United fan, wouldn't you feel
equally as bad because
you think to yourself, there are 3 points everywhere. Just get the home games out of the way. If they got the home games out of the way, they would be second, third place, at the least.
But again, I think similar to Liverpool, I can't put my finger on what it's inexplicable. Like, why can't United beat these teams?
Man United rely on one goal scorer.
It's not like they don't create, they create. So why aren't
they? They rely on one man to put the ball in the net. And that man has gone and done 6, 7 goals this season? He's already done that much.
If he's done that much, he should be on 37 by now.
Well, but that's the problem, you see, is because Zlatan could get 5 chances in a game and score one of them.
Yeah.
So it does look like he should have had more, but, you know, it's...
Yeah, Zlatan's been great, but I still feel like he could have scored more goals.
Yeah, what do you do in that scenario, though? Because if you're Man United now, do you give him a new contract and knowing that it's going to jeopardise both Martial and Rashford? Because as long as Zlatan is there, those two players are not going to be centre-forwards for Man United.
If Zlatan's not there...
Are they ready?
I think it comes down to are they ready?
No,
are they ready to win the game for United?
No, I'm with you, yeah. But the thing is, this season, nobody expected United to win the league, innit? It wasn't like a bored expectation.
Big man, people did.
No, but it wasn't
when
a bored...
at how much they spent.
I'm talking about as a board. It's not a board expectation just for, like, straight in.
You don't think so?
No. He's did a football manager terminology. It might have been a media expectation.
No, hang on.
Because I'm saying, say for example, you had Martial and Rashford all season up front. Yeah, they learn it all. You give them 38 games to pair and let them learn from their mistakes this season, where it doesn't really count for Mourinho. Next season, you kick on.
Don't you think it's Man United every season?
It is Man United. But the thing is...
When you sign one of the best managers in the world, in Jose Mourinho, you spend 200...
Van Gaal had how many seasons?
Van Gaal is not Jose Mourinho.
It's not about that. If Mourinho had no silverware this season, they would not be questioning his job. They will know that, look, this is a horse that needs to... It's the Chelsea scenario.
This league position.
Listen, with
no Colin Cup, I don't think he would have got sacked.
Listen,
only because it's his first year. I don't think he would have got sacked either.
That's the point.
When he came back at Chelsea the second term, the first year was all about, let me steady the ship, let me get the horse ready, and next in the summer, I'm going to buy 1, 2, 3. Guess what he did? He won the league clean.
But that year, the year he came back, we should have won the league that year.
I know, and Man United are thinking the same thing.
And United, looking at that squad, they should be challenging for the title at least.
But look at that, copy and paste it, bruv. Imagine Man United potentially next season. Because Mourinho knows what he needs to get rid of. He already knows what he needs to buy.
Yeah.
He's already thinking like that.
He's scheming. So
when we see what Man United do this summer in terms of transfer window, we're all going to be like, for flip's sake.
But they do bits every year, United.
No, but it's got a manager now. It's got a manager that they can rely on and trust. Because you couldn't trust Van Gaal and you couldn't really trust Moyes. So it's got a manager that where they say, do you know what? Give me 3 years. If I don't bring you a Premier League title, sack me. And that's the kind of man Mourinho is.
He's a brand in himself wherein players will want to come and play for him.
Look at how
David Moyes, they lost out on people like Cruz and Bale because they didn't want to play for David Moyes. Jose, because he's a reputable guy, people will want
to
come.
Look at Man United's brand in the last 6 years. Since Fergie's cut to now, you think to yourself, look, it kind of slowed down in the Moyes era. And in the Van Gaal era, it was a bit here and there because it got Falcao, it got Di Maria, but it was a bit here and there. Mm. Look at it now. It's bigger than ever before.
What are you talking about?
Man United's social brand right now is bigger than it's ever been.
Van Pogba has an emoji.
Yeah, no, I hear that. But like you just said, when it was Van Gaal, they still managed to attract Di Maria and Falcao.
Because there is a bit of history that it was leaning on.
I agree, it's gone up, but I don't think it's going to hold another plateau.
My point is this: this summer, be worried, be afraid, because Man United will. Mourinho is already looking at it, and I'm talking about Mourinho. I'm not talking about Man United. I'm talking about Mourinho knows exactly what he's going to fill. He knows what holes he needs to fill up, and he will get that sorted by June. He will have that team ready for the season next year, and you watch how scary Man United will be next season. But my question is, should they keep Zlatan? Because I think Zlatan is going
to
stunt the growth of Martial and Rashford.
Yeah, no choice but to keep Zlatan, and I think if you're a good young player, then having good players ahead of you can only make you better. Like, I understand you need game time, but you're learning from these guys in training every single
Rashford
day.
Rashford's on the wing. He's not even playing centre. My point is, he's not playing centre forward. How am I not playing my position? And then you're going to, you know, Rashford's stats have gone, I'm sure, have decreased like crazy since last season. Last season he came in and bang.
Yeah.
Imagine you were told that, you know, this year, just steady the ship. All you have to do is stick Rashford up top. You never know what kind of goals you've got to get from this season.
Look at where United are right now with Zlatan playing out of his skin.
Yeah.
And, you know, they're sick. I still think they're going to make top four, but If you take Zlatan out of that, I don't think they will.
No, but
yeah, if Zlatan can't play for the next 10 games, I'm not so sure United are going to make top four.
No, but my point is that it doesn't matter. That's my point. It doesn't matter this year.
It does matter.
Not this season.
An Arsenal fan whose whole thing of Wenger has been the fact that he's managed to make top four all these consecutive seasons. You're saying it's okay for Mourinho to not make top four?
But relax, listen. What I'm saying is Mourinho's a new manager. He's come into a new side. He bought a bunch of new players. These things don't work. These players are capable of challenging for their league. They are, but my point is, it's longevity. It's not about today. It's about when he builds this. Because you look at the team that Mourinho built, when you look at Chelsea in their title-winning season, you thought to yourself, oh, Lord, who's going to break this team?
Have mercy.
Who's going to do anything? Because Mourinho came into that Chelsea side, looked at what he needed, and he bought the ingredients where it became unstoppable. That's my point.
You know, I agree with what you're saying.
No, because
dropping out of the top four is unacceptable for a minute.
Yeah, listen, they're out of the top four last season.
I know.
Right? No, but
my
point
is, Van Gaal's not there no more.
Yeah, but Van Gaal. But
it can't be a habit, though. I agree with Oscar in that sense.
I'm with you, but when Van Gaal had two bad years, It's not because he had one bad year and they just got rid of him. He had two very mediocre years where when he got in the Champions League, they got knocked out in the group stage. So it's not like it was, you know, it's not like he had a great year, bad year. Mourinho, it's, like I said, they trust Mourinho. He brings success to any club he's been at. So if you tell me that you sign, how many years did they sign Mourinho for?
Was it three?
Was it a three-year deal?
Sounds right.
In his first year, it will not be questioned, is my argument. He will not get questioned in his first year, regardless. If he finished seventh with no trophies, but you know he's building exactly what he's doing, they will trust him for the second season. If the second season ends up being the same as the first, cool. Then you might have to get rid of him. But I think next season, don't play with Man United, because I think Mourinho's got something planned. And I hate to say it, because I hate Mourinho and I hate Manchester United. But you know, I think that if you have taken Zlatan out of this equation and let Rashford and Martial learn the Premier League, show them what a season is like, you never know what it could have been next season. You just never know.
Or even in this current season.
Or even in the season, exactly. Because for me, I think they still bag goals. And now we won't know, because if Zlatan signs another deal, guess what? Rashford has to go on loan. He just has to. If he wants to progress, he has to go on loan and play centre forward. And play centre forward for whether it's a Hull or, you know, a Championship side. He has to, for Sunderland probably, if they go down. He will have to be a centre forward. He has to be. Martial's getting wounded out there. They're getting wounded over there. Do you know what I'm saying? So, you know, that's what I feel about Man United. But it's looking up, though. If I'm a United fan, I'll think, you know what? There's positive stuff. There's the FA Cup still on the horizon. They're the best team in the Europa League.
Three cups.
They can leave with a treble, and it's still the first year. And it's still the first year. And the Premier League title will be their only goal. It will be, let me just kill this title. I've done everything else. And Mourinho, when he's got his eyes on something, don't play about it.
I'll be honest.
You know that more than me. I mean, come on. You know this better than I do.
If I was a United fan, I'd take a treble and finish outside the top four this season.
Why haven't you won a treble this season?
FA Cup.
Oh, Europa League. Yeah, I forgot about Europa.
So, not a proper one, but winning three cups this season.
I agree with you, only because the Europa League gets you in the Champions League.
Yeah, plus it gets by virtue.
Yeah, if you get back in, fine. Yeah. I'd surrender this season. Yeah. But it's just because it's a cup.
Top four to win the Europa
It's just a cup, innit? It's just that it's a cup. You can't even dare. You can't even dare do it. Do you know what I mean? You can't even dare do it. But yeah, Bournemouth, I don't know if there's anything to mention on Bournemouth.
Very impressed with them, because I'm a big critic of Eddie Howe. I feel like he's the type of guy. No, I like him as a manager. I think he's a very good, innovative, he's got good ideas, young manager. But my problem with him is he doesn't switch it up. Like, he will play Howe at home.
What is he, Wenger or Jace?
To a degree. hence why people always link him. So he'll play the same way against Hull at home, and he'll go to the Emirates away and play that exact same way. But this Bournemouth side, they showed a great resolve, showed great spirit. Arthur Burridge, he's been poor all year. He had the game of his life.
Everyone has the game of their life.
Do you know how poor Burridge has been?
Did you see the goal he conceded last week?
Holy cow.
When the ball just bounced everywhere and he just patted it back. No, it was shocking stuff. So yeah, Man United only got a point, still didn't make it into the top four, still in sixth position. Yeah.
The worst thing is, because did they actually create enough to win these games? I don't know.
They play better. And that's another thing that they can take and say, you know what, we're playing Man United football again. We're playing very good.
I don't know if you guys have seen it, there's a video going around Twitter of like, it's like 2 minute long video of just United missing so many chances.
I didn't. Do you know the worst thing? All of their misses was on that 2 minute video.
It will be a season at the end of the day where they'll look at it and think, oh, it's just rude, you know, we've rude missed chances. But listen, man, anyone would have told you they would have that over what they've had over the last three seasons. They would have what's going on now.
Because it's better. It's
they would have what's going on
it's
now.
It's a progression.
They've got a cup under the belt and they're playing better football and their manager's Mourinho. There's a lot of people who are happy. They're happy with that.
Happier.
You know what I'm saying? Man City, on the other hand, you know, job business as usual, professional job. 2-0 winners against Sunderland. Mm. Leroy Sané coming into his own as well. Aguero with the spoils. So you know, pretty professional. I think City people are falling asleep with, but they're nicking points. They are nicking points.
Underground's doing their thing.
Yeah, they are nicking points. I don't know what you lot are thinking about City.
I've got a quick question actually.
Yep.
I was listening to like a snippet from Talk Radio, and it was Ray Wilkins, and he was very passionate.
Man like Ray. Oh, what, the England rant?
Yeah. No, because you say player like Leroy Sané, he's coming into his own.
Mm.
He's obviously a big money move for foreign kids, and he's been allowed and sort of slowly integrated into the team, and he's been given time. But then City, they've got youngsters like Patrick Roberts. Why are they not afforded the same opportunity as these foreign lads? Like, do we not have in this country youngsters that are capable of doing what these foreign lads can do that we tend to buy for 20 million right now?
Yeah, good. It's a good point. I felt Ray's passion there. The only thing I'd say about that is, you know, I'm not going to call you a foreigner, but you have a background of another country, for example, right? Mm. And you're a billionaire, you're a millionaire, you've invested money in your club. Guess what?
You
don't give a damn.
You don't give a flying forex. You want to win.
Because at the end of the day, you're going to be in the minus if things don't go well at your club. You want to win trophies, you want to win everything.
Look at it from, like, for example, Chelsea spent 30 million this window on Batshuayi.
Yeah.
Doesn't play anywhere.
Yeah.
Yet you send young Tammy Abraham out on loan, scored 20 plus goals this season.
Yeah.
So,
no, good point.
Wouldn't you rather use the English talent?
You would.
That's costing you far less.
No, you would.
Far less.
You would, but they're both. The thing is, they're both on the bench. Whether it was Batshuayi or him, the argument still stands that Tammy's on the bench. And to be fair,
but you didn't need to spend 30 million on Michy.
You didn't. If
Tammy's there.
I'm with you.
But you just don't believe in Tammy because he's never had the shot.
It's true.
He's never had the chance to prove himself. And that's the case of so many English players.
But let's deep it. Let's keep it 100 all the way up. Are the English players good?
We don't know
if they don't play.
Fair enough. But
like look at Marcus Rashford. Some people may call it Van Gaal's brilliance.
Yeah.
But I feel like he came into that United side fortuitously by chance.
He would have never been in that team.
And look, he grabbed the opportunity with both hands, and look at the end of last season that he had.
No. You're absolutely right.
He was at the Euros.
You're absolutely right. What I mean? So but you know what? No one's complaining about Leroy Sané, a 19-year-old German, right? Bought for I don't know how much money, right? And you're talking of your Patrick Roberts and these lot. Players that play in that similar position, your Oliver Burks and all that lot, they are there, but when you're playing the way you're playing, Gabriel Jesus is how old?
19.
Guess what? No one's batting an eyelid about an English striker his age. They don't care because the point is, I can't find you that 20-year-old striker who's as good as Jesus, or I can't find you that player who's as good as Sané.
Now, you see, not to say that they are.
For example.
But not to say that they are as good, but we're forgetting that. When Jesus is playing for Palmeiras or whatever it is, he's starting as a young boy. Now I'm not saying Man City should go and starting 18 years from the academy.
Yeah.
But I'm saying that it's clear that you get better if you play.
Yeah.
So if these young English lads aren't playing,
yeah,
how on earth are they going to get better?
It's a great debate. Because even that Sané one, because you've just cancelled my argument with that right there. Because even Sané played for Schalke for a long time in the first team. Yeah, yeah. German team, he's a German player and he's in the first team. Maximilian Meyer, another one. Draxler. They've all been playing from young.
Because these men, they're like 21, Ozil, 22, but they've been playing for like 5 years.
They've been playing for like 5 years. Yeah, exactly.
Oh, yeah.
And so until the Premier League, I guess, stops filling on this hype of European talent or foreign talent, it will never be like that. Because if you imagine, right, if we went back to a league where everyone's team had to be English, had to be British, right?
No, that's... That Premier League years.
You know,
the Stamford Bridge was like, only had two quarters. Only half court.
Imagine they said you could only have three foreign players in your first team, in your 25, right? It would be completely different, and then we would see the best of the British, we'd see the best of the... And that's the way you get all those players. You know, we'll see a Tammy Abraham up against a Chuba Akpom, up against, you know, who's your fella? Woodburn. You know, you would see, imagine seeing that talent go against each other, where you've got Welbeck probably the star of it, and then you know what I'm saying, you've got all that kind of thing. Harry Kane, I mean, these players are, England could have one of the best players. You look at Southampton's youth team, what on earth do they do over there? Do you know what I'm saying? They've got a brilliant set of youth teams.
I think we would be
better than even Germany and Spain's, but they have to get over this hype of European stuff, over the money. They have to get over the hype of these foreign owners. They have to get over the hype of all that. And until that changes, I'm sorry. Because you look at Germany, right? You name me a German team that's owned by a foreign owner. You couldn't even name even the German owner of that team. You go in Italy. Okay, Italy's a bit funny because they've got
a lot of corruption.
Look at France. France is... The French league is French. It's just French lot, if not French-speaking African countries. It's all there.
Did that one.
Mbappe's how old?
CDM from Cameroon.
Mbappe's 18, 17. starting for Monaco, Champions League games as well. He started his first Champions League.
I know. The question I'm going to propose, would Mbappe start for Man United?
No.
So then...
No, because they've got to get over this hype. That's what I'm saying. I think England need to get over this. And just, and if we could really be English and say, you know what, let's take all this intoxication of foreigners, get them out, and let's play with the English British teams. You allow three foreigners in your squads.
Oh no, that's never gonna happen.
No.
Which is a shame. Yeah, it is a shame. But you can see the talent is there. The talent is there. Because look at the players I just named, and I thought, how exciting would that be to see? You know, them lot fork it out.
It would. How exciting.
When
you said it, I was like, oh, that would be...
Do you know what I'm saying? And then you've got Kane and Welbeck are the lead of that. Sturridge, they're the leading of that
pack.
They're
not that good, though.
No, they're good, man. I
think... Welbeck. If it's Kane, yeah.
Welbeck, Sturridge and Kane. That's a good three. Oh, come on, Oscar.
It's not...
Danny Welbeck is a different... He's different class right now.
And speaking of Welbeck, yeah, he's... I feel like when he scores, yeah... It was like it was put on this earth to do that. That's all he was meant to do.
And I told guys from day when we signed him, I said, let him have Wenger. Let Wenger have him for 3 years.
Okay, but Wenger had Walcott for 10.
And Welbeck's a better player than Walcott. That's just how it happens.
That's just how it happens, man.
Trying to cookie crumble sometimes.
Exactly. Let everybody get players from around their area. Let's get, you know, let us have the Islington lot. You lot have the Fulham and Broadway.
It's great, but it's like...
That's a Fulham Broadway.
What you're saying is like, it's like discussing how great communism could be. It's just like, it's not going to happen. So let's just move on.
No, I think one day, because you know what, football, nothing stays the same in football. Over years, 10s and 30s or 20s of years, things change a lot of the time. And when we all have our kids and we have grandkids, we will be looking at football in a whole different world. What we will be telling them is so foreign. Will be so foreign to them. Yeah. So, you know, you look at our parents now, what would they tell us about football back in their day? Do you know what I'm saying? Like, this whole thing of a foreign player, excuse me,
it was
what?
It was black and white.
It was black and white, and John Barnes. It was, you know what I'm saying, Phillips, names like Smith.
When we have kids, we're going to tell them, one day Arsenal won the league, like, back in the day.
Shut your mouth,
and they're going to be like, what?
Arsenal, huh?
Shut your mouth.
I feel like, no, it happened, cuz.
I can only really see Huddersfield won the Premiership in like 1932. You're thinking, huh?
Man City. But you get me. So yeah, but anyway, but Man City, professional job. I think if Chelsea are not careful, watch your backs, because City are they're winning, bro. It's W's.
I see why you say that.
It's just W's right now.
I feel like City are in Bournemouth and
the beach.
Yeah.
Oh, like on the beach, you mean?
Yeah. No, even that. Like, I'm just thinking like geographically. City are in Bournemouth.
Yeah.
And Chelsea, they're about to touch Victoria on the way home. That's it, fam. They're far away.
I don't know. How many points are City away from Chelsea? Isn't it six? Before tonight's game?
Six. It can't be six.
Yes,
it's before tonight's game.
No, it can't be six.
No, it's seven before Chelsea play.
It's seven points. But
we're currently on the same game. Like, Chelsea played 26, Man City played 26, and they are
so if they win this,
eight points behind us.
They're 8 points behind you. So if they win if Chelsea lose and City win their game in hand, right? They don't have a game in hand, do they? Or they do?
Over Chelsea.
Yeah.
What do you mean?
No, City will play to have a game in hand because they're playing on the weekend.
We're level on games now.
No, because City had a cup game, whereas Chelsea didn't.
No, City are playing on Wednesday.
Oh, you are playing on Wednesday.
Yeah, City are playing on Wednesday.
So when City play on Wednesday, they'll have an extra game, and that's because Chelsea are going to catch up on the weekend.
Okay, yeah, okay. So if City win, they're 5 points behind you. Then is basically the story. If City win their midweek game,
Chelsea are playing this week.
You know what I'm saying?
They're playing tonight. That's what it is, because they're playing tonight.
You know what I'm saying? We're level on games as we speak.
If Chelsea win today, they will go 11 points clear.
You will go 11 points clear.
Okay.
Have a game in hand. So
it could go down to 8 again.
The gap is 8 points.
I thought Spurs and City winning was going to make the things very squeezed. What happened?
What do you mean?
I thought the points were a lot more squeezed than that, because Spurs won and City won. And so they were talking about it potentially being 7 points, 6 points. That's what I thought. Is it really 8 points? I'm quite surprised by that. I'm very surprised by that.
City have been quietly plugging away.
But anyway, they're plugging away, and I think if Chelsea need to get this job done professionally, they just need to have a professional job between now and the end of the season. Don't think of the season as over, because the minute you do start thinking like that, you will get caught. So, but yeah, City getting away with it. I'm happy with City, man, because if I was a City fan, I'd be gassed, because I'm thinking, I got Guardiola, We've got a good team coming through. They've got good players. Next season they'll be a force to reckon with. They're doing well in the Champions League. You know what I mean? They're good. Like I think everything's looking rosy. FA Cup is in their sights as well. So yeah. You know what I'm saying?
You said they're doing good in the Champions League. You think they'll go through?
I don't know. Because Monaco away is tough, man.
The thing is, they
conceded three away goals.
So if Monaco score twice, that's it. Well, yeah. With no reply.
Yeah.
That's not going to happen.
I think Monaco win like 3-1. 3 or 4-1.
Could this be the year City make it to their first ever Champions League final?
No. It's not ready yet. It's just not ready yet. It's the same thing with everybody else.
Well, we say that, but they absolutely spun Barca.
They did, but then they got spun too, didn't they?
Yeah, they both did. Barca. They did get spun.
I mean, they could play. You know, who would they fear? How would they fare against Bayern Munich? How would they fare against Real Madrid?
We'll have to see.
I really wish we were in the Champions League.
We all can't be in there. We can't all be there at the same time.
Yeah, you'll find out at the end of the season.
But yeah, Man City getting a professional job done. Tottenham 3, Everton 2. Your boy Harry Kane yet again. Man like Harry.
I have to ask you the question again.
No, you can't. You shouldn't ask me that question.
What's your assessment of Harry Kane?
Listen, let's talk about the game specifically.
Right, cool, let's go.
Two gifted goals for Harry Kane.
Yeah.
Did you see?
Yeah, I watched the full 90 minutes.
First goal. You're just hating on it.
No, the first goal was this. On so many fronts was this, yeah? First of all, it was poor defending and it was poor goalkeeping. Yeah. It was poor on all fronts. Do you get what I'm saying? So, but I'm not taking away his finish. Guess what? Top quality finish. I'm not taking that away. The second goal. Oh my God, the second goal.
Big man, he was gifted the ball.
The second goal.
You have to put a ball in the back of the net. There's plenty of strikers that wouldn't have scored that.
Thank you, yes.
One of them being Olivier Giroud. So it's like...
Leave Giroud alone. I never put Giroud even in that echelon.
Ah, cool.
I don't even put him in that there.
For me,
you want to talk about a striker. Did you see Lukaku's goal? Because I tell you what, to put Vertonghen on your bum takes some feet, right? Then the way he buried it, I'm sorry, it reminded me of Henry.
It was just
Henry-esque. And the celebration that went with it, I said, I love this guy. And I tweeted, this is what Arsenal need. I don't care, Wenger, get your checkbook out. If it cost you 60 million, sign Lukaku 60 million.
If I got a pound for every time I heard you say that.
What, Lukaku?
No. Oh. Wenger, if I had a pound for every time I heard you say, Wenger, get your checkbook out. Yeah. Guess what? We could have actually bought the players.
Brilliant. As a striker,
rather 10K.
Listen, guys, he is 23 years of age. Lukaku only is a beast. Let me tell you, the thing is, he plays for Everton. He needs to get... He can't be in an Everton shirt next season.
Yeah, record goal scorer.
He can't be. He overtook Duncan Ferguson yesterday.
23 is their record goal scorer.
He's been there for like 3 years.
Is it record in the league, though?
Yeah, in the league.
It was in the league, yeah. But like, he overtook Duncan Ferguson, bruv. And he's the one that coaches him.
Big dunk.
The big dunk. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, honestly, Lukaku was second. He had one shot and he just took that away. He took it away and I said, that's a strike. That's what I want. I want him at Arsenal badly, guys. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to lie. He's big, he's strong, he's 23
And guess
years
what?
Of age.
That's another one that I'm sure when he gets his big money move, Wenger's going to come out 2 months later and say,
We could have signed him.
When he was at Anderlecht, you know.
Yeah. Overall, I think we...
It was the money.
We were unlucky. No, of course. It could be.
It's slowly... That Lukaku is slowly creeping up onto the Mourinho L's list.
Mourinho's L list?
De Bruyne, of course, is just a big L by Mourinho. Lukaku is slowly becoming a Mourinho L.
What was the Robin scenario?
Iron Robin, oh my.
Because that was weird.
But Bertrand's not necessarily to that degree, but he's...
But yeah,
he's good enough.
I'll give you that, Ryan Bertrand.
I'll let it go.
It's like fair enough. It's not like world Kaka? Class. It's not like world class.
Would you say Kaka in that bracket?
Yeah, maybe.
Wait,
what happened with
Kaka? Because he just ruined him. He just ruined his career.
Is Cassius, is that guy as an L for Mourinho?
The only thing is, what's his name? Lopez came in and he was all right. He could justify it.
He justified by winning the league with
the
other
people were saying that the whole Schweinsteiger thing was a bit of Mourinho L.
Yeah. I'm with that because he's still a top player. I'm with that impression.
And the reason there's an L's list is because Mourinho is such a good manager. Like, this is not pirate Mourinho. He's saying he's got so many lists of accomplishments but the L's have to come with it.
That's a nice spin.
It's not like, a diss on.
I like that. That's a nice spin.
Yeah, Romelu Lukaku. I'm so sorry, guys. That's a guy I've got the hots for. He needs to be signed at Arsenal.
Steady on.
No, because honestly, it was too. You go watch Henry's goals for Arsenal. Yeah, it was always, why was he left open by himself to go 1-on-1 with the keeper? All of Henry's goals 1-on-1 with the goalie. This scenario yesterday was just shades of that. I just had flashbacks of Thierry Henry, personally. That was
every time I think Lukaku's not that good, I remember like he's 23.
And you know what is, when you think he's not that good, he starts scoring again. Because he does have his spurts. He does have his moments.
6-game run where he don't score, and then bang, bang, bang.
But you remind yourself, oh, Everton were garbage yesterday. By the way, I was watching the game pissed. Not it being only Tottenham, but the fact that when Arsenal play Everton, guess what? Why are we going to be jittery? We will be jittery. Tottenham just put this game to sleep. Okay, 3-2 is the scoreline, but it flattened Everton because Everton were god-awful that game. They were terrible. By the way, it was suicidal of Koeman to play Gareth Barry ahead of McCarthy because Gareth Barry was getting to no balls. Slow. Especially against Dembele and Wanyama. He was getting to no balls, nothing. Dele Alli having a time of his life. His finish, again, awesome as well. Great, great goal from Dele Alli. So Tottenham as well, they're keeping pace. They are second or third?
Tottenham are second, but City have a game in hand over them.
As I was going to ask you about Harry Kane, yeah? Oh, God. No, would you say potentially world-class is unfair? Because I'd class him. I say he's potentially world-class.
Is Harry Kane potentially world-class?
Providing he does a few things, such as win, turn up in Europe and...
I don't think that's fair. As in when people say, oh, you have to win, or you've got to win the Champions League to be world class, you've got to win.
The Harry Kane debate is interesting, but because, like, 2017, he has been something else. He's probably been the best striker in the league in 2017.
What's his record? Like 19 games, 22 goals.
You don't need to tell me how good Harry Kane is. I don't know.
It's hard to answer that question, Adrian. It's hard.
Because obviously, Lukaku, I think we could all agree, he is.
He doesn't do it at the big stage.
And it's like, you remember this time at the Euros when everyone was like, why did Harry Kane start every game?
He doesn't do it at the big stage.
That's exactly what everyone said at the Euros.
Let me go with that. Because he played in the Champions League this year. He had six games.
That's what I said, potentially world class. That's what I said. When he starts doing that,
they were. I forget that. Lest we forget.
From the rented out and Wembley.
And they'll be renting.
For Falcao to have a party, you know.
They'll be renting it out all next season. Brilliant. I don't mind that at all. Is he potentially world class? I don't know, man. I don't know. Because I'm looking at his goals and I think, you know, he's not a Defoe still. Do you know what I mean? He's still not a Defoe where, by the way, do you see Defoe's shot when he hit the post against Man City? Like, there's moments in the game where Defoe takes the ball and he does something out of nothing. He should have no right to be shooting from where he is. I don't know, man.
Fair play. I don't know.
Do you know what I'm saying?
In my opinion, I think he is, but, you know, fair play.
I will give him this credit. He's a very good striker.
Thank you.
You know, that's a good enough compliment.
So he's moved up from good to very good. That's more than enough for me.
Is this his fourth season? Third season? And he is racking up goals. He is racking up the goals. You know what I'm saying? So, but, you know, you ask me, Lukaku or
yeah,
Kane?
Yeah, that's...
You ask me, really. In your first team...
It depends on what team you are.
Chelsea.
Lukaku.
Arsenal.
Lukaku.
Manchester United.
Kane,
yeah.
Why?
I don't know. I just feel like he's more United player.
I feel like with that service...
He hasn't got the pace.
Never does Latin, really.
Yeah, but I think that's why they don't score that many. As much as Latin has got that many.
No, but they don't score because Latin misses.
But they've all got... Man United's attacking threat has got pace surrounded, bar that one man. Bar that one man. I think Lukaku gets more goals for Manchester United than Kane does. Personally. That's just on a personal basis. Yeah, Man City...
I mean, it's hypothetical, isn't it?
Yeah, of course. Man City.
So, if so, buts.
Kane or Lukaku?
I don't know.
Yeah. You know?
I don't know.
For me, Kane just doesn't fit a big team yet.
For me, I think the stain of Spurs is what's clouding people's assessment of him.
Yeah, very true. Very true. I think the fact that Spurs will do something again this season that will make us all laugh. We know that's coming. through what... I mean, they've already made us laugh losing to Ghent. I mean, you know, if it wasn't losing in the Champions League, which we haven't given them stick for, and losing in the Europa League, again, we haven't given them stick for, they've probably already done it. Do you know what I mean? But,
if Kane was an Italian, if it was like Harino, Kanellini, and he was banging and he was banging for Sampdoria, I think he would be one of those young strikers who look at it and we go,
it's a Belotti situation right now. You look at Andrea Belotti right now. Precisely. Top goal scorer in Serie A, right? He's 22 years of age.
That's how I think we'd look at Kane.
Lethal striker, right? I think he's lethal. Yeah. He had a hat-trick. He scored a hat-trick in 9 minutes yesterday. He's lethal.
I think it was even eight.
Was it 8 minutes? Yeah. And Kane's done something similar like that before. Mm. So, you know, it's almost like, yeah, you're right. You stick a foreign accent on it. We could rate him a lot differently if he played at Sampdoria or whatever. But
I was gonna stick a foreign accent on it, but there's no way to spin Harry Kane. Can he? Make it sound.
Can he?
Could it be Harry? Harry is the most interesting.
No, not Harry. Harry. You could even do Harry. But it could be Harry. You know,
but it's so mad that
Henrique.
Henrique Kane.
Kanye with the accent.
Kanye with the accent on the E. Yeah, absolutely.
Enrique Kanye.
Oh, yeah.
Fantastic goal from Enrique Kanye.
Yeah, no, but I think you are right. There is a bit of stain. And I got to see... And I said that before. I said, I got to see him out of that club.
Mm.
I've got to see him in another club where he does do the thing. But for Spurs, even at the big stage...
Yeah. I agree.
I'm not with that.
Hence why I wouldn't dare to put him in that category. That's why I said potentially. That's what he needs to start.
And that's another argument somebody could bring about Lukaku. And I wouldn't go against
Lukaku. Really had much of
a but game. I am looking at him thinking, how he's an Everton player. He's lasted this long.
Mourinho Ailes.
If he's an Everton player next season, oh my God.
it'll be out of loyalty more than anything. Oh,
please.
But then again, you see how I was saying this to Mourinho Ailes, at Chelsea, Lukaku wouldn't get games. He's got games at Everton and he's proved to us that he's this good.
See, goes back to the original argument about the whole England's player thing.
Oh, he'll be the number nine at Arsenal. Make no mistake. Every game. Make no mistake.
The only thing is, he misses bare. No, Lukaku.
Lukaku he's frustrating. Misses.
Bags
he
frustrating. Of chances.
No, Lukaku misses, bro.
But it's good to learn that at 23, 25, 26, guess what kind of breed he could be. He could be different class. And so could Kane.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so could Kane.
I think people forget, really Kane's 23 as well.
I really feel like Kane can't get better, though. He's really good. I feel like he can't get better than he is as a player. I feel like he's reached it. Whereas with Lukaku, there's still potential. He's still a potential.
I think Kane knows that. That's why he likes to do stuff. Like, he likes to come deep and get the ball. It's almost like he wants to show us he's got more to his game.
There's something weird about it. We can't put our finger to it.
Yeah.
Any other games to talk about? Southampton getting four.
Inexplicable.
Getting four away at Watford. That's a feat, isn't it? If you score three goals at home, it's still lose.
Yeah, it was a great win for them.
My man, Gabby Adidi, yet again. Oh, I love the fact he's doing well, man.
To be honest, the only reason why he's here in the first place, it's not necessarily him. It's just players have been ahead of him.
Hmm. The Higuain curse. That Higuain curse at Napoli really dented his career there. Yeah. But he's back there. He's scoring. He's now scoring goals. And, you know, good luck to him as well. Good win for Southampton. Very yo-yo kind of team. But you know, I think they'll get it together.
I got to Watford scoring three at home and not winning.
Yeah, you know what I mean. it would be. Yeah, Watford is a very weird team as well this season. They're very weird as well.
Nathan Redmond playing well for Southampton.
Lately. Yep, Redmond's looking good. You know, you hope he does get a good stint out at Southampton for a couple of seasons and get his name. Because you look at a Redmond now, to me, he's better than Sterling. I think he's better than Sterling. I'd rather have Redmond than Sterling.
Ooh,
no, I do. Personally, I do. Shall I tell you what he has ahead of Sterling? He has end product.
Why are you saying wild statements, bro? No, he doesn't.
Bro. Slow your roll. Because in the last, is it 11 games, Sterling has had a goal or an assist. No, he's had like 9. In the past 11 games, Sterling has had either 9 goals or assists.
He's got like a 9 Sterling in terms of goals or assists.
Yeah.
Fine. I prefer Redmond. Let me just say that.
You prefer who you want. But to say one's better.
I prefer him. I'd love to see Redmond get more the amount of games and coverage that Sterling gets.
But he's not doing the same as Sterling, so you can't even say that, bro.
Yeah, but because Sterling was at Liverpool and Man City. Those are the spotlight clubs. You know what I mean? Those are the spotlight clubs.
Yeah, but there's a reason Redmond ain't getting a spotlight like that.
But look at it. Gabby Adini's been tremendous. No spotlight for him. He's been tremendous.
He's getting spotlight on the top 4 podcast.
There we are. But, I want to give Redmond his fair due as well, because he was awesome against Watford, by the way.
Okay. I think Redmond's good. He's one of those players you put in your fantasy team. But he's not...
He's coming. He's young.
He's young, yeah. I think that's the word for him. He's young. He's unfinished. 22?
22.
I think he's 94. 22? No, I think he's 20.
No way. 24.
No, 94. He was born in 94. So, so what does that make him? 23.
That makes him 22.
22.
So just yeah, 23 this year.
Yeah.
Next year.
This year, bro.
How old did you turn?
I turned 24 and I'm...
Oh, you're 24? Bloody hell.
My whole age on the pod. Yeah.
I was like, if I had NI number as well, well, you're right.
Yeah, no, Nathan Redmond is 23.
Okay.
Born March 6, 94. His birthday is today.
Oh, big up. So he was 23 this whole time?
He was 22. 22
this whole time. Told you lot. Don't worry, world class, 25 years old.
Okay, but look, we're talking about Harry Kane and Lukaku at 23.
Yeah, but I'm talking about that English debate we were having earlier. When you look at the English caliber,
Harry Kane's English, bro. Harry Kane started for England in the Euros. Oh, where was Nathan Redmond?
Yeah,
he's not at that level, bro.
Come on. No, he was loyal to Mirage, isn't it? He went down with them.
He's not at that level, cuz.
That's another Birmingham product, you know. Birmingham put out some players, by the way.
Him, Butland,
Gray. Butland's good news for Butland, by the way.
Garbage, because when the Euro list came out, Sterling was in that list. No one was chatting about Nathan Redmond. You weren't bigging him up then. Nathan Redmond should go to the Euros.
The
USA.
I didn't say that. I didn't even say Nathan. I'm just saying.
It's purposely obtuse.
You are being purposely obtuse.
Just leave it. Be purposely obtuse. It's just supposed to be difficult.
Let's move on, Oscar. Any other results from the weekend?
Leicester City.
Oh, for flip's sake. These vermin. These absolute scum. I haven't had my rant about them yet. This vermin club. This scumbag on the side.
You know what I mean? When I heard that from Remy Ball, yeah? I was like, holy smokes, what's going on?
Each of those Leicester players need to have a hard look in the mirror and call themselves scum written above their mirror. They are absolute vermin, the lot of them. Mm-hmm. They got their manager sacked by Downing Tools all season. And then you beat Liverpool and hold back-to-back.
Two wins on the bounce.
They haven't done it all season. They haven't done that all season.
Yeah, but it's like men lie, women lie, numbers don't.
Oh, shut up. Leicester, I want Leicester to go down. I want them to go down. I can't stand them. They are absolute scum. I don't even blame the owners. Shall I tell you why?
Yeah.
Because do you know what?
That's what I said.
I'll be honest with you.
That's what I
Ranieri's said. Ranieri's still in the job. He goes down with them. I think Leicester go down.
Yeah,
because they were in such a rut.
I agree. For me,
no, they were, then what are you complaining that day?
No, because he deserves them to... He still deserves...
For what he did for that club,
he deserves to have a year in the Championship with Leicester City. He deserves it at the minimum. Give him the opportunity to come back and bring them back up. Because it's because at the end of the day, let's deep it. What have they got to lose if they go down?
Their status.
No, I can't lie, bros.
They won the league,
no,
bro.
No, one's going
to
go relegated.
At the end of the day, bro, they won.
And plus, you say what did they have to lose? They could fall into obscurity. Do you remember Middlesbrough? How many years were Middlesbrough in there?
No, I get you.
No, it's big. It's big.
Look, I worry more if Sunderland went down than Leicester City. In a sense that I think Leicester City bounced back up. Look how Leicester are playing all of a sudden. How can this team be playing like this just the next couple of games?
Yeah, but if they drop to the Championship, they lose Vardy, they lose...
Yeah, get rid of the Deadwood. Get rid of the guys that did not want to play. Get rid of them that didn't want to play.
They lose good players, though. They lose drink water. They lose other guys.
But then they can birth new talent. They've got a youth system, haven't they? They can nick a few players from around the leagues that are...
From scratch, big man. Yeah,
bro, all I'm saying is Ranieri deserved... At the end of the day, the players are the reason why that happened.
Principally, yes. But when we look at it, through a logical lens, no way.
Can I say something very bold? You know me, I'm full of bold statements every week. It's not that deep going down. It's not that deep. No, it's not that deep. Because you can come back. You can come back, bro.
That's the worst thing ever.
You can come back, but what is the fear? It's not that deep.
No, but that's the thing. Like, the scenario with Leicester City is so... No, but I hear you. But it's so unique.
Now, Peter, have you seen Blackpool? Have you seen Blackpool recently?
No, I ain't seen them for a piece. But
would you do a year in pen?
No, of course not.
Exactly.
How are you relating Championship football to jail?
It's not the same thing.
It's not the same thing. It's not the same thing. That Premier League life. Bro, Leicester always come in and out of that league anyway. They would the first time that they came back up.
Yeah.
The first time since 2004.
And now they've turned their life around. They're giving their life to God on that. You want them to go back into Pen?
Listen, those players. All their contracts should have been terminated. It's worse now. It's worse now that they're playing better now. It's so bad that what manager even wants that job? That's the most undesired job right now.
Yeah.
No. Who the hell wants to take that job?
What are you going to do? Be better than the last manager?
Did you see Mancini emphatically said no on Strictly Come Dancing in Italy. How can you even reject a job like that? How did you reject a job like that? And he played the
Man City. So I was going to be in this waltz.
Leicester. Yeah.
No. Leicester? No. Those players got me mad against Liverpool. I was angry for 100 reasons in that game. I was livid. Mm-hmm. Livid. Kasper Schmeichel, shut your mouth as well. Chatting too much. Always chatting.
Did he ever
ask the question, do you have something to play in this whole thing? He just dodged the question every single time. They are scumbags. A whole lot of them.
I heard they met up with the owners in Seville.
In Seville? In a hotel. Oh my God, I can't even... No.
That's espionage. That's
scum. Yeah. How can a group of players... You know what a manager is, brother? Yeah. Have you ever gone to work and you meet the manager? Like, that is untouchable territory. You cannot even dare even get him sacked.
How
do you even... That HR department, whoever they are, whatever it is, they all... I'm furious.
I heard, where's Morgan? Rubbish, crap, awful, god-awful, terrible, where's Morgan? Had the unmitigated goal to go and get the man sacks who won you a Premier League.
I'm hot. Them men are in debt to Ranieri for the rest of their life. Oh, a lot of them.
If Ranieri needs a kidney, they give him a kidney.
Give him the kidney. Give him the kidney.
And give him your lung where you're at it as
give
well.
Give him the kidney, bro.
Bro, how dare you?
Wes Morgan won the league, lifted the league title, bro. You know people like Gary Neville, Ryan Giggs, Tony Adams, Vieira. I'm saying these lot who lifted the Premier League title. Worthy guys, John Terry, worthy legends of their territory. Wes Morgan is in that conversation. Yeah. He's in that conversation. These guys are
even
taking
Tim Flowers back
taking,
there.
They're taking the piss. Taking the piss, bruv.
Ultimate piss.
Fuchs. Who the hell are you, bruv? Who the hell are these players, bruv?
Danny Simpson.
Man United reject. Newcastle reject.
Danny Simpson without
QPR reject.
For goodness sake.
To be honest, I thought you held them up, though.
Unbelievable.
I thought you dealt with Carragher.
Some of those players need a slap in the face. I cannot believe that this is actually happening in today's football. I am red hot about that situation. When I found out about that, they sacked Ranieri.
They got him sacked.
I was furious.
They had a meeting. The force. What was it?
I was Schmeichel, furious.
Morgan. I think Vardy.
Should have known that from Schmeichel all along. Yeah, his dad was a verminator as well.
It reminds me
and
of
maybe Drinkwater was the fourth.
The whole Leicester City
scumbags.
It reminds me of the Blackburn thing when they won the league and the next season they were just bad. But it's nowhere near that level.
Don't get it twisted. Because everyone has that debate of, this is Leicester City. They should always be fighting relegation. For me, I'm not of that opinion because you can't win the league and then it just goes.
That's the Michael Owen thing.
Michael Owen
was
saying
that.
No.
Chas, he's a messiah fam, Mystic Mike.
Oh, whatever.
Well, whatever he says comes to fruition. he was talking like Ozil talk from 2013.
But you know what, bro? It's this thing of like, you can't, listen, the league, you can't win the league.
Mike,
you can't win the league on fluke. You just can't.
Yeah.
By luck. You can't do it.
You can't go three.
It's too long.
Only lose three times in the season.
It's too long.
That's not luck.
They lost only three games.
That's not luck.
It's too long.
You showed something. You showed something.
Scumbag of a side.
We've got just over 10 games left at the end of the season. Yeah. Let's say Leicester go on a run, win 7 or 8 of those games, finish mid table.
Yeah.
Was sacking Ranieri the right decision?
It's never the right decision. There's nothing that will change my mind about this. There's nothing, especially in the manner in which Oscar, they did things.
I think ethically is wrong, but
it's not even about ethics. The fact that Leicester City, from a business perspective,
I don't know.
He won them the Premier League. I don't think we're not going to deep this for, because the problem with winning a league, innit, you have to get over it in 2 months' time and start your title again, start your race again, and that is the problem because you don't get to feast on it. We still feast as Arsenal fans on the unbeaten season. We still have songs about it now. We've got it. So it's a thing of, this thing is legacy business. Mm. When them man had their parade, bruv, 250,000 people were there. 250,000 in the UK, in Leicester City alone, were there gathering for their thing. It was like Glastonbury. It was unbelievable. No, it was packed. Did you see it? It was like as if, you know, like when Obama became president.
That's when Kanye was on the main stage.
When that whole shit, Kanye.
An Oasis.
Bruv, this is history that you cannot take the piss out of. You just can't do that. That is what you call taking the piss. That's why I'm pissed off about it. That's why I'm livid about it. Because I cannot believe this. I can't believe that a manager can do something. He did miracle work.
Turn water into wine.
He did miracle work, bruv. This is so that they can see the glory of God. This is unbelievable stuff. on a serious level, like it was. It's for the non-believer. That scenario is just for the non-believer alone. And I was one who did not believe that can happen.
He took an Algerian in Riyad Mahrez and made him player of the year.
He was player of the year.
Can you do that?
He was player of the year. Once again.
And deservedly so.
Oh, yeah.
Deservedly so.
Had
an amazing season.
No doubt.
So it's like, what?
I can't fathom this scenario. I can't fathom it. It is unbelievable. These players, none of them are worthy of winning a Premier League title. None of them. None of them before last season.
Okazaki, get out of here.
None of them last season, before last season, should we have ever put their names in the same. It's insulting to do so. None of them, bro.
To get that team into the top 10 last season, that is miraculous in itself.
I'll tell you what's worse.
That in itself is unbelievable.
You're asking about if they finish 10th, is it worthy of the sacking? Let me tell you what's even worse. If Ranieri finishes 17th one season and finishes 14th this season, guess what? He keeps his job, doesn't he?
Mm-hmm.
This is a disgrace. It's an absolute disgrace.
It's an aberration.
That's why.
To let that man go.
Because if he finished 17th last season and he finishes 15th, 16th, 17th this season, he would have kept his job. He would be in a job right now.
Because you won the league.
You
took them to heights.
Because you won the league. How can you get based on that?
He took them past the precipice.
Bro, he took... Listen, this is...
He took them to the promised land.
There it is. Ranieri is a normal guy. I can't believe it.
Livid.
Pizza boy. He's used to going Nando's. Livid. He's used to taking his girl Nando's. One week he said, I'm taking you to the Shard. The next week he tried to take her back to Nando's. She's having none of it.
She's not having any of it.
She said, I'm Shard levels now.
Who the hell do you think you are? What were you before you came and took you?
I picked you from the slums, the village, the shanty towns. I prepped you up, bruv. I held your hand at the school disco and everybody said no. Bro, this is ridiculous, bro. I'm sick and tired of this crap. No, it's honestly, I am red hot. I don't support Leicester City. I don't. But I am red hot. Never have I wanted a team to win the league one year and get them relegated the following year. I hope they go down. I hope all of them go down.
Same.
I hope so. Because this is unbelievable. I looked at the whole game. I thought, this will be tricky. But if they beat Hull, I'll be hot. I'll be angry. I will be angry. How do you turn the tap on and off, like Neville said?
Man, I'm buying the shirt, you know.
How can you turn the tap on and off like that? How can you? Do you know how unprofessional that is?
Forget professionalism. You as a man, integrity. You have nothing.
The integrity, honestly. No morals. Not one of them am I giving a blind. Not one. Kante, you're the only one that can get it. Because I'm sure I would have never seen a lackluster performance from Kante this season. Even as a Leicester player. This is unbelievable what we saw this season. It's unbelievable. You know, in years' time, we're going to be talking about this again. In years to come. But look, the Premier League, third manager who's done that. Fourth even. Mancini, Ancelotti, Mourinho, now Ranieri. Wins the league one year, gets sacked the following. It's disgusting. It's disgusting. I can't... Like I said, I don't think it was that deep in it for it to go down. Because it is Leicester City. But
I think we've covered all the games.
Flipping out. I'm pissed. I don't know why did you even bring up
a player of the week?
Who's the player of the week? Who's the player of the week?
The guy that you think is amazing, Nathan Redmond, is a good shout.
I'll give it to Harry Kane. I've got Harry Kane.
For me, honourable mention, Adam Lallana. He was
not a bad shout.
Phenomenal. Mane as well played well.
Start bad shot.
I'm going to go with David Luiz.
David Luiz?
Just foreshadowing what's going to happen tonight. I'm joking.
Whatever.
I want to give it to Nathan Redmond.
Oh, after all that.
I like the guy, but you said he's better than Sterling and that rubbed me the wrong way.
I've got Harry Kane.
So what's this? I've got Lallana.
You've got the... is it a tie three? Okay.
How do we split this?
What's your reason for Lallana? We see who's got the best reasons. What's your reason for Lallana?
No. I understand football's it's all about numbers and it's all about
goals and assists, but
when you sat down and you watched the work ethic of that guy for 90 minutes, it was like, not only was he like the Bionic Bunny, he also had the class, he also had the ability. Like, he's a tremendous footballer and he played well and he ran, what's the saying? When you is it run out of your shirt?
Yes,
I know. Socks, or is it run out of your skin?
Run out of your skin.
Yeah, yeah. He ran out of...
That was the first time I said to Peter, Lallana was excellent.
And listen, and to typify it all, this guy has busted his backside for 90 minutes. We get a corner. He takes the ball out. He's running at full pelt.
The pivot.
He beats a man. And the easy option, he saw Origi straight offside. Yeah. The easy option would have been to pass it to an offside player. No, not Adam Lallana. Not the wonderful man that he is. He turned, he came back to make sure Origi played onside and he played the ball after. Nah, man. For me, anyway, yeah. That's my reason. That's why. Reason.
Kane, player of the season of 2017. Let me get to the end. He's been consistent. Throughout, and I think this weekend to bag two goals against Everton, he could have had a hat trick. By the way,
on this podcast, you just said how Kane was gifted two goals.
He is, but he scored them.
But he was gifted.
You asked me for the player of the week. No, we're not debating. I'm not debating if he's a world class striker. I'm debating on who's had the best performance this week.
Fair play.
That's what we're debating.
Let bagels be bagels.
Yeah. Word up. Let me.
He was gifted two goals. Alright. even Vardy's in that list.
Yeah, Vardy.
What did he score twice?
Oh no, he did. He just got an assist.
Got an assist.
He did get a goal.
He didn't get a goal?
No, it was Fuchs, Riyad Mahrez.
Oh, he scored twice against us. That's what it was.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. If you're counting in last week, then
yeah, because it was Monday.
Yeah. Redmond bag two, bruv. Away from home.
He got an assist as well.
At Watford, yeah, and I think he got an assist
for Tadic. Did he?
Let me see.
Oh, Tadic.
Tadic got two assists and a goal. Bruh.
What, Tadic as well?
Tadic is up there. Sadio Mane got an assist and a goal. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You know, it's unfortunate because whenever Mane has an amazing game at Anfield, I always tend to pick a midfielder. So obviously, when he against Spurs, I think I said Wijnaldum gets it. And then
we need to get this one over the line, Baz. Who are we going to choose?
I think you should relinquish your Kane argument because of what you're
saying. All right, I'll relinquish it. It's not. Oh, I did that.
So then you've got a pick then between Lallana and Nathan Redmond.
Nathaniel Redmond, I'll go with him then.
Fair play.
Because it is the away win, and he was influential. The only thing I'd give Mane on more than anything else is that I'll be doing it based on his season. He's been an absolute instrumental player for Liverpool this season. He did it against the big lot, again against Arsenal, where he murdered us in the first game of the season. So you know, he did it against the big club. I'd say that. Yeah, fine. But
moving on, team of the week.
I think Bournemouth is a shout, but I'd have to go for Liverpool.
I mean, if we ain't done a podcast in a couple of weeks, yeah.
Oh God, so where's he going?
You have to put Leicester in contention for team of the week.
No, we do. No, we do.
They beat Liverpool. They beat Hull.
Shut up, man.
They scored six goals.
Southampton away win. You score four goals away from home.
Because
Leicester, this was a team.
God,
Leicester didn't score a single goal in 2017, I don't think.
Do you know what? I would give it to Liverpool, but because they frustrate the hell out of me with their defeats, that's the only reason that stains Liverpool.
We're talking about team of the week.
Yeah, and I'm saying Liverpool would be my team of the week. Because they beat Arsenal at home. Yeah? They beat Arsenal at home.
Remove it.
You've got to remove everything that's happened previously and just look at this week and say he is the team of the week. You can't be out here saying, yeah, 3 weeks ago you annoyed me.
No, because they do. Because Liverpool give you this performance when... Who's your next game? Burnley at home.
And guess what?
Technically, we're recording this podcast on a Monday. Liverpool versus Leicester was last Monday. Oh, in the past, guys, in this week, it's been Leicester. Leicester have been the guys.
I'll be honest with you. Wouldn't do it like that.
Because if they don't get it this week, they would have got it last week.
I can't even admit that. I can't get that out of my mouth.
Nah, bro. Let bagels be bagels.
No, I can't. Not now.
Unless you want, what do you want to do? Do you want to go for City, who won 2-0 at
Southampton? I said Southampton. They scored four away from home.
I know, but they conceded three, blood.
They won 4-3.
Man, like Troy Deeney scoring.
That's my potential, anyway. Let me not talk. No, for me, Liverpool, we boxed.
Liverpool, for the fact they bounced back and beat Arsenal.
My vote was Leicester, but I guess
Liverpool gets it.
Bournemouth had a good performance as well. Away.
We're moving on to goal of the week.
You nicked my one. I thought Deeney's goal was nice.
Is it?
I liked Lukaku's. I didn't see Deeney's, but I like Lukaku's.
Nice.
So Wan-Mi-esque. That's a goal I watched for weeks.
I didn't see any worldies this week. Like, anything that was like, wow.
Yeah. Like, Mane had a good finish. but
We need to talk about West Brom Palace, by the way. West Brom Palace was hilarious. How could it? Palace won 2-0 away.
Do you know what? Do you know what we didn't talk about?
Wilf. The boy Wilf.
Yeah, go on. What do you mean?
We've had a shocking year this year in refereeing. I think we can all agree. We could all sing for the same hymn sheet in that. But I don't think I've ever seen a team get penalised for a handball and it resulted in a penalty when it was the attacking team that handballed it. So we're in the Swansea penalty box. And a Burnley striker, I think it's Sam Vokes, the ball hits him on the arm. So you think to yourself, whoa,
free kick.
That'd be an indirect free kick, right? The goalkeeper, Paul Robinson or whoever. Fabianski, he kicks it up the field. Yeah, no big deal. But what I didn't expect was for the referee to point to the spot to award Burnley a penalty. He must be having me on.
Shocking stuff. I don't know. The refereeing this season has been awful.
It's been our all-time.
You know what I mean? Sanchez scored a basketball goal and it stood.
And we just missed. Now we've missed Mark. Mark's gone off.
I don't know if he has. I've been hearing it's going back and forth.
I was going to say he's wrestling. He's refereeing a game on Friday.
I heard he wanted to come back. Like the move went sour.
Yeah, I heard it was off. I heard it was kind of off.
Because I heard he actually realised where he was going.
What a moron. What was it?
From Al Hilal versus...
Goal of the week.
Goal of the week. Sorry, yeah, mine's Lukaku's, but go on. You look.
I do like Lukaku's. Go on, AJ.
Mine was Dini.
Oh, but even Kane's was good,
though,
to be fair.
Do you know what? Yeah, I don't want to be a waste man and pick another goal, so we have to choose again. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to go with Lukaku.
Lukaku gets goal of the week. And what, not that guy? I've got someone.
David's not here to do not that. David's guy. Not here, who's gonna do it?
I've got one.
Oh, he's got one.
I'm sure you don't have one too, no?
Well, not that guy is not really the thing where we throw out suggestions.
Fair enough.
You just get one thing and you just run with it.
All right, fair enough.
You read man's Wikipedia.
You see that you've got a passion, so I'm gonna let you go.
I mentioned earlier on the podcast that this man is committing suicide.
Have you got the stats?
No, because I'm talking about this week.
Huh? No, as I said, he was born in 1934.
In
Paris.
Let David have that one. That's what makes it special.
You
don't encroach a man's gimmick.
To make it repug.
Can't be stealing my stick.
To then make it to make it repug as well. I said earlier that this man committed suicide. He turned up to Liverpool, with his star man on the bench. Didn't even leave him in London. He brought him to Liverpool, so there's clearly a reason why he's even in the squad. He then brings him on at halftime. One thing he never does. He never does that, right? He never brings a player on at halftime. He brings him on at halftime, and guess what? Makes this man look like him a fool out of himself because he was awesome when he came on the pitch, right? He then does the unforgivable. He takes off the best player that was on the pitch that day for Arsenal. He takes off Danny Welbeck and he sends him off whilst the Arsenal fans are singing Danny Welbeck throughout the rest of the night. And then it's the same old Arsenal who turn up to a game where they don't look any different. It's just the same old thing. We turn up to a big team and guess what? We look like ants in comparison to everybody else.
Like ants.
We all look like ants.
Minuscule.
Just tiny, tiny people. No one with no strength, with no passion. He sat down the whole game until the 90th minute when he started barking at the fourth official. And I'm livid that we're in this scenario. I want him in, but I can't defend the guy. There's nothing to do to defend this guy. Arsene Wenger, you're not that guy, bro!
Sort it out!
I'm sorry I had to do it, but
alright, let's quickly go through the fixtures of the Premier League. Well, tonight we got West Ham Chelsea. Are we going to go through that quickly?
Draw.
Away win.
Go with the draw.
Up to Chelsea, 3 points. Alright, now, this is confusing.
Who am I kidding? It will be Chelsea, isn't it?
Some of the games are like,
yeah, because teams are playing in the FA Cup.
We're playing FA Cup this
week.
So Arsenal's not playing this week.
Should we do FA Cup games?
I don't really care.
It's just the quarterfinal.
Yeah, it's the quarterfinal. It's a prediction, isn't it? Yeah.
Alright, but then I have to go to another. It's long.
So what are you doing now then? It's going to be longer.
I'm on the Premier League app right now with the fixtures, isn't it? So I have to get out of the app and go online to get the FA Cup fixtures. It's all a bit long. But, alright, cool.
But I think we know them off head though.
Till we get there, West Ham. Wednesday, Manchester City versus Stoke.
City home win.
Aguero hat trick, please.
Calm 2-0 win.
I triple captain him. I need it.
This is a whole week of football. I just think I forgot. Tuesday night, Arsenal vs Bayern Munich.
Arsenal 4, Arsenal 3, Bayern Munich 0. Go out by the one goal yet again. I think it'll be 4-1 Arsenal. Nah. What am I kidding? Who am I kidding? We're losing 2-0. What am I talking about?
Yeah,
we're
going to lose 2-0. Yeah, 2-0.
We're going to lose 2-0.
Yeah, no, I'm going to put Arsenal win 2-1. Alright, and I think City will beat Stoke. Saturday the 11th of March in the Premier League, we have Bournemouth versus West Ham.
West Ham win. I think Bournemouth, that horrible defence will come back.
Yeah, all agree. Full house, West Ham. Everton versus West Brom, 3 o'clock kickoff.
Everton.
No, you know what? 2-2. 1-1.
Nah, Everton win.
What are you saying, bro?
A draw.
Everton win.
Everton will be West Brom. Should do it. If Lukaku wants to be considered one of the greats.
Because he's former team.
Hull versus Swansea City.
Oh!
That is a 6-pointer if I've never seen one.
That's a 3 o'clock game. That should be on TV, man. I've got that all day. Paul Clement is coming to the Bayern game tonight. But I'm going with Hull. Home win.
Not really down for watching Hull.
Hull home win. I'm loving a bit of Marcus Silva.
Hull home win.
Yeah.
All right, go on.
Yeah, Hull home win.
Hull. Their home record. Their home record is fluky.
Fernando Llorente.
Have you noticed he was scores and twos?
That's why I said I've got two words for you.
Ooh, I like that.
Is that a fantasy thing?
But the only time I see him score,
Llorente's been in my fantasy since Liverpool, bro. You man ain't ready.
The thing is, he was proven before he came in.
No, he's been a good striker his whole career.
Right, like it was a coup. Swansea getting him in the first place was a coup. Yeah. And I think he's got like 12 goals now, is it?
Yeah.
Alright, last Premier League game of the weekend, Liverpool versus Burnley.
Listen.
Ho, ho, ho.
Jurgen Klopp, if you're at home in Merseyside right now, I want you to be in your little office place. Your hand is over the button. You press the red button. Operation Anfield Slaughterhouse. We need to bang this team. 4-0, 5-0. I don't give a monkey's what it is. We need to bang this team.
I'm going with a Burnley away win.
Oh,
First away win of the season.
I will rip my hair out. I will be so livid. I'll never come to a podcast ever again if we lose that game.
Do you know what? This season is just full of repeats. Whatever you want to predict will come to pass.
No, not this one.
I'm going with a Burnley away win.
Not this time.
Sean Dyche will set it up just right.
No. Liverpool win at the Cop. Moving on to the FA Cup fixtures next weekend. We have Middlesbrough at home to Manchester City in an early Saturday kickoff.
You know what?
I'm going to put 4-0 Manchester City.
Hey, guess what time this game kicks off at?
Oh, it's a shoddy time.
What, 12:45?
It's like a 12, no. five, like one, what, like 5 past 1.
No.
What time?
Do you want to guess?
I've guessed.
I know, but like...
12:35.
No, incorrect.
11 o'clock.
Incorrect.
What region is it in? What hour is it in?
It's in the hour of
12:15.
Incorrect. It's 12:15 kickoff. What even is that?
No.
It works out nicely for time. Because obviously the half ends at 1 o'clock.
I know, but what does that mean?
Maybe.
Like, as in, you know how last season it was 12:30 kickoffs? Now this season it's 12:45.
It's because it depends who owns the team.
Maybe the FA Cup is 12:15. Maybe, like, what's all that about?
Maybe there's traffic.
We had a 2:15 this season. It was shocking.
Alright. Arsenal Lincoln, 5:30.
1-0 Arsenal.
Come on. And Arsenal
win. Arsenal have to do that at the Emirates. Come on.
To the Arsenal.
Wait, Peter, if you don't win that game, is that a sackable offence?
No, not necessarily
in itself.
Oh, yeah.
Is that the straw that breaks the camel's back?
What? Upstairs in the board?
Somewhere. Like, no. Someone has to go. No. Someone has to relinquish.
No. I'm the next game. I'm the kind of person, yeah? Whenever Chelsea win, lose, or draw, like, I wear my Chelsea kit, I support my team in it, yeah? But you could not pay me £1 billion to stand outside White Hart Lane while they face Millwall in my Chelsea shirt. Spurs versus Millwall.
Oh, the security must be on fleek. The police. Oh my god, mate. The police. I want to see Millwall at Wembley.
Right now, certain men are cleaning down the baseball bats.
Bro, I'm telling you, right now.
Shining it up
real nice. Nah, it's got to be a Spurs win. They'll put the first team out. It's got to be a Spurs win.
Yeah, man.
Well, in all of the teams that you know you wouldn't expect to win against a big Premier League side, we haven't gone for any upsets.
I hope there's an upset.
Are we not believing in the magic of the FA Cup?
No, do you know what it is? I feel like magic can only go so far.
Yeah, it doesn't go to.
It might get you past the round four, But when it's quarterfinals, teams start bucking up their ideas. They're like, you know what? They're like, you know what? Realistically, we can win this. You're not going to be playing your kids.
Monday night, it's a big one. It's Chelsea at Stamford Bridge hosting Manchester United.
Oh, for goodness
sake. MNF, yeah?
7:45. This is our...
Please, United. You know what? The last time United lost was this game.
Who do I hate? Man United or Chelsea?
Wait.
I don't know.
Are you being serious? That's the last time they lost?
I think so.
Who, Man United?
They are beating runs going mad. Now, they lost to Hull. I'm not having it,
Yeah, but it was in...
Nah, but he lost, though, innit?
Second leg.
In the league.
Can't have been Chelsea. That was time ago.
He's saying in the league, though.
Oh, it's not?
No, my bad.
Oh, sorry, I thought it
was... This is far. That can't have been the last defeat. No, surely.
They lost the Hull.
Surely.
And they won the game,
too. Who would you rather have in the semi-final, Chelsea or Man United? I'd rather have Man United.
Yeah, of course you'd rather
have Man United. I'd rather have Man United. I'm not on Chelsea in the semi-final at Wembley. Not on it.
No, I don't blame you.
I don't blame me.
I wouldn't be on it either.
I'd have it in the final. Don't get to the final.
Yeah, because once you get to the final, you're going to choose who you face.
All bets are off.
Yeah, I hope United win, but I think Chelsea... Mourinho's coming to win. Yeah, Mourinho will win at Old Trafford, whatever it's called, Stamford Bridge.
I really wish this game was at Old Trafford. I'd love to go to Old Trafford and beat United.
Yeah, would.
We'll just save that for the league. I think Chelsea... We'll see as Zlatan-less United. If Zlatan was on the pitch, I don't know.
Oh, crap, he's not there, innit? Extra time and penalties, man. That's going to extra time. That is going to extra time.
At the Bridge, I don't see it.
It's going to extra time and Chelsea will win.
I don't see
I've changed my mind.
I don't see us going extra time.
It'll go to extra time and Chelsea will win.
The Blues.
Blues? Full house?
The Blues.
Boys in blue.
Who else? Right. You missed someone out, haven't you?
I've missed no one out.
Liverpool, you know,
Liverpool in the league, and we mentioned Burnley against Burnley. So next weekend there are Premier League and FA Cup games all around.
Cool. So we're convening back when Arsenal are through to the quarterfinals of the Champions League.
So Amanda, you better pattern up your fantasy football teams.
Yeah, it's time now. This is the business end of the season.
I'm top of the league.
Don't worry.
You man needs pattern.
Wait, bro. In fact.
Oh, am I not top no more?
Listen,
on
Thursday morning, you're going to wake up with a nasty surprise.
I was chatting
when you see certain man on top of you.
Anyway, thank you for logging into this week's top four. It's been a minute. It feels like it's been ages. We will be back next week. Make sure you like, subscribe, share. Top four podcast on Facebook, on Twitter,
all of that.
On YouTube, all of that. On SoundCloud. We are everywhere, all over the bits. You done know.
I thought I was going to say something else there.
Yeah, I thought it was getting X-rated.
Did I lie?
All over the ends then. Let me try that one.
Remember, what did you say about Lukaku earlier? I thought it was getting a bit rookie there.
He's got the hots for Lukaku.
Hey, look.
Fair play. It's 2017.
It's a new era. It's a new era. Yeah, make sure you log in and subscribe. You're done though. Watch out for us next week.
Peace.
Bye-bye.